mad and you're just destroying yourself. The maid and the cook have gone off fruit picking, and every single living being is rejoicing that only you sit here in this room all day as if it was a convent and don't take any pleasure. Yes, really, I reckon it's the whole entire year you haven't even left the house.
I shall never go out. Why should I? My life is already at an end. He is in his grave, and I've locked myself between four walls. You're both dead.
Well, there you are. Nikolai Mikhailovich is dead. It's the will of God, and may his soul rest in peace, but you can't go on weeping and wearing and mourning forever. You know, my old woman died too. When I was 19. I grieved over her for about a month, and well, that was more than enough for her. But if I had to grieve for an entire age, well then, the old woman definitely wasn't worth it. You don't go out anywhere and you see nobody. We live, so to speak, like spiders in the dark and we never see the light. My lady, you are young and beautiful with rose in your cheeks. If only you were to take a little pleasure. Beauty doesn't last long enough. In 10 years' time, you'll want to be a peahen yourself amongst the officers. But they won't even look at you.
I must ask you never to talk to me about it. You know that when Nikolai Mikhailovich died, life lost all its meaning for me. I vowed never to the end of my days to cease to wear mourning or to see the light. You hear? So let us go see how well I love him.
Instead of talking like that, we ought to go have a walk in the garden, or else order Toby and Giant to meet. Or go and drive, see him some neighbors. Dear madam, what is it?
He was so fond of Toby. He always used to ride on into the Korchagins and the Vlasovs, would brace them with his finger when he pulled at the reins with all his strength. Toby, tell them to give him next week of votes.
Yes, madam.
Who's that? Tell them that I received no money.
Yes, madam.
You will see, Nicholas, how I can love and forgive. My love will only die out with me when this poor heart will cease to beat. And aren't you ashamed? I'm a good and virtuous little wife. I have locked myself in and will be true to you till the grave. And aren't you ashamed, you bad child? You deceived me, you had rows with me. You left me alone for weeks on end.
Madam, somebody wants to see you.
Didn't you tell them? Since the death of my husband, I've stopped receiving.
I did. The devil curses and pushes himself for it.
I do not receive.
I told him so, but he says it's a very pressing affair.
Very well, Asimid. What matters? How these people annoy me. What does he want of me? Why shall he disturb my peace? Maybe I shall have to lock myself into a convent after all. Yes.
You fool, you're too fond of talking.
Madam, I have the honor of presenting myself. I am Gregory Stepanovich Smirnov, landowner and retired lieutenant of artillery. I am compelled to disturb you on a very pressing affair.
What do you want?
Your late husband, with whom I have the honor of being acquainted, died in my debt. For 1,200 rubles on two bills of exchange. As I'm about to pay the interest due tomorrow, I've come to ask you, madame, to pay me the money today.
1,200. And what was my husband in debt to you for?
He just, he used to buy oats from me.
So don't you forget,
Malora Tibby, tell me an extra feed of oats.
If my husband wasn't dead to you, then I shall certainly pay you. But you must excuse me today as I have it in the spare cash. The day after tomorrow, my steward will return back from town, and I'll give him instructions to settle your account. But at the moment, then I'll do as you wish. Moreover, it's exactly 7 months today since the death of my husband, and I'm in a state of mind that absolutely prevents me from giving money matters my attention. And I'm
in a state of mind,
which, if I don't pay the interest due tomorrow, will force me to make a graceful exit out of this life.
Feet first. They'll take my estate.
You'll have your money the day after tomorrow.
I don't want the money the day after tomorrow. I want it today.
You must excuse me, I can't pay you.
And I can't wait till the day after tomorrow.
Well, what can I do if I haven't the money now?
You mean to say you can't pay me?
I can't.
Is that the last word you've got to say?
Yes, the last word.
The last word.
Absolutely.
Absolutely.
Very well.
And then people want me to keep calm. I meet a man on the road and he asks me, Mercury, why are you always so angry? But how on earth am I not to get angry?
I want the money desperately. I wrote out yesterday, early in the morning, and called on all my debtors. And not a single one of them. I was just about dead beat after it all, so goodness knows where in some inn. And now, I'm here, 70 birds from home, hoping, just hoping, to get something. And I'm received with a state of mind. Now how shouldn't I get angry?
I just thought I just simply said that my steward will pay you when he returns from town.
I didn't come to your steward. I came to you. What the devil? Excuse my outspokenness. Have I to do with your steward?
Oh no, sir, I'm not accustomed to listen to such expression or to such a tone of voice. I want to hear no more.
Well then,
state of mind. Husband
died 7 months ago. Must I pay the interest or mustn't I?
I ask you, must I pay or must I not? Now suppose your husband is dead and you've got a state of mind and nonsense of that sort. And your steward has gone with me somewhere. Double take. What do you want me to do? What do you want me to do? Do you think I can just fly away from my creditors in a balloon or what? Or do you think I can just go and run my head into a brick wall? I go to Bresto.
And he isn't at home.
Yurkovich has a...
oh, hidden himself. Had a violent round with Kritsy nearly threw him out the window. Zugo has a matter with his bowels, and this woman has a state of mind. Not one of the swine wants to pay. Just because I'm too gentle with them. Because I'm a rag. Just weak wags in their hands. I'm much too gentle with them. But just you wait. You'll see what I'm like. I shan't let you play about with me like that, and I'm confounded. I shall jolly well stay here and sit here until you pay. Oh, my insides are quivering with anger. Give me a glass of water or something.
The man is in desperate need of his money, and
she won't even pay.
Because, you see, she isn't disposed to money matters.
That's really silly, feminine logic. That's not what I never did like. And don't like now to have to talk to women. I'd rather sit in on a beer of gunpowder than have to talk to a woman.
Can't even look at one of these poetic creatures from a distance without breaking into a cold sweat out of sheer anger. Can't even look at that.
Madam is ill, and we'll see.
Get out!
No.
Get out!
Ill!
Or we'll see nobody.
That's all right!
It's all right, you don't see me.
It's all right.
I'm going to stay here, my dear.
We're going to wait until you pay me.
You can be ill for a week if you'd like.
And I'll stay here for a week.
You can be ill for a year. And I'll stay here for a year.
Don't forget my own. My dear. You don't get at me with your widow's weeds and your dimpled cheeks. No more dimples.
Simeon, take them out. We aren't going away at once. Tell them in the stable to give the horses some oats.
Well, give up then your horses get tied up in the lathes again.
I'll give it you.
Oh, it's too bad. It's frightful.
No!
Told you perfectly, plainly,
I want the money today. I want it. I swear to God, if you don't pay me the money today, I'll have to hang myself tomorrow. What can I do if I haven't the money now? You're so strange. You mean to say you can't pay me?
I can't.
Very well.
Very well. It's okay. It's okay. I'll stay here until you pay me.
You're going to pay me the money after tomorrow?
That's all right. I'll stay here until the day after tomorrow, and I'll sit here all the time.
To get sour. Madly, every blessed way. David, I used to chatter like a magpie about emancipation and wasted half of my wealth on tender feelings. But now, you must excuse me. I shan't let you play about with me like that now. Confound it! I've had enough! The moon whispers timid breathing. I wouldn't give a brass farthing for the lot of them. Present company woman.
Great or little.
Are insincere. Crooked. Bad types. Liars to the marrow of their bones. Vain. Trivial. Merciless. Unreasonable. As far as this is concerned, you must excuse my outspokenness. Espero can give 10 points to any philosopher in petticoats that you'd like to name. When you look at one of these poetic creatures,
oh, muslin and an ethereal demigoddess, you have a million transports of joy.
And you look inside her soul and you see a common crocodile. The most disgusting thing of all is that this crocodile, for some reason or other, imagines that it's just before. Its privilege, its monopoly, is its tender feelings. Why? Confound it! Hang me on the narrow feet upwards if you'd like. But have you ever met a woman who can love anybody but a lapdog? When she's in love, can't she do anything but snivel and slobber? While a man is making sacrifices and suffering,
all her love is expressed around with her playing about with your scarf and trying to hook him more firmly by the nose.
You have the misfortune of being a woman.
You know from yourself the nature of a woman. Tell me truth. Have you ever met a woman who was sincere, faithful, and constant?
You haven't, exactly. Only freaks and crooked, wicked, old women are faithful and constant. You'd see a cat with a horn or a white woodcock sooner than a constant woman.
Then according to you, who is faithful and constant in love? Is it the man?
Yes. The man.
The man!
Men are faithful and constant in love?
What an idea!
What right have you to talk like that? Men are faithful and constant in love?
Since we are talking about it, I'll tell you that out of all of the men I knew and know, the best was my late husband. I loved him passionately, as only a young, inimaginative woman could love. I gave him my youth, my happiness, my life, my fortune. I breathed in him. I worshipped him as if I were a heathen, and what then? This best of man deceived me at every step. After his death, in his desk, I found a whole drawer full of love letters. And when I was alive, it was an awful thing to remember. He used to leave me alone for weeks at a time and meet up with other women and betray me before my very eyes. He wasted my money and made fun of my feelings. And in spite of all that, I loved him and was true to him. And not only that, but now that he is dead, I am still true and constant to his memory.
I don't understand what you take me for. As if I don't know why you wear that black domino and bury yourself between four walls.
I should say, I did. It's so mysterious. So poetic.
When some lame drunk or some tame poet walks past your window, he will think,
oh, there lives a mysterious tomorrow who, for the love of her husband, buried herself between these four walls.
We know these games.
What? How dare you speak to me like that?
Oh, you may have buried yourself alive, but you haven't forgotten to powder your face.
How dare you say all that to me?
Oh, please don't shout. I am not your steward, and you must allow me to call things by their real names. I am a woman, and I'm used to saying what I think straight out. Don't be shouting.
I'm not shouting, it's you! Please leave me alone.
Pay me my money, and I'll go.
I shan't give you any money.
Oh, no, you will. I shan't give you a farthing just to spite you. You leave me alone.
I have no interest in being either your husband or your fiancé. So please, don't make scenes. Don't like it.
I even feel sorry to have to kill her.
not dimpled, I like her. I'm even ready to let the debt go, and I'm no longer angry.
Here are the pistols. But before we fight, you show me how to fire. I've never held one in my hands before.
Fallen in. into a mousetrap like a mouse.
Yeah, then I'll fire.
Fire then. You don't understand what happiness it would be to die before those beautiful eyes. To be shot by a revolver held in a little velvet hand. Look at that, out of my senses. Think. Make up your mind at once, because if I go, she'll never see each other again. Besides now, I'm a landowner, a respectable character, have an income of 10,000 a year, I can put a bullet through a coin tossed into the air, and I own some fine horses, and will you be my wife?
No. Let's go and fight!
I'm mad, I understand nothing! Waiter, water!
Let's go out and fight!
Kid, I'm in love like a boy boy. I love you as I've ever loved before. I refused 12 women, and 9 have refused me, but I never, never love any one of them as I love you. I'm weak. I'm wax. I'm melted. I'm on my knees, offering you my hand. Shame, shame. I haven't been in love in 5 years. I've taken a vow, and now, all of a sudden, I'm in love like a fish out of the water. I offer you my hand. Yes or no? You don't want me? Very well. So, well, nothing, go away. No, stop. No, go away! You only knew how angry I am! How angry! My fingers have swollen because of all of this! Why are you still here?
Goodbye.
Yes, go away! No, stop!
Toby isn't to have any more oats at all times.